combo, the knock-up and the slow. It can be a lot of damage that comes down to Singh. Oh, he gets the death sentence. Nifa's in trouble. Ignite is out. He's forced to flash. That's first blood for Hyunin. Because Singh shows up in his debut performance in 2015. Job against Maokai, as you would somewhat expect from the fact that Lulu can bully a Maokai. But early dragon here for HTK, this should be uncontested.
Good timing again. You can see how Rekkles was down to 50%. I believe Nif was actually out of mana. He started recalling. And then HTK knew, okay, we have all the pressure in the bottom lane. We have all the pressure in the mid lane. Notice how Froggen is pushed to his tower. He can't go anywhere down. Push it up one more wave and then go straight to mid lane.
Well, Ryu gets in lane.
Down.
The second chain does not. Ryu may be able to get a counter. One for one. Ryu manages to get a reply on Froggen.
If Sword Knight picked up for him, he can go straight to mid lane, take down this turret, and then return to the bottom lane when Rekkles had already pushed it out. But again, Element, they're expecting it, so they keep ganking Ryu in here.
Oh, Ryu's in so much trouble. Knocked up, locked down. Death Sentence connects. Shook is the reply. Here comes Lulex. Cataclysm is available. He slam dunks down onto Froggen. Look for the right target. It's the one with the chain. Hyunin continues to auto-attack. That's a double kill for Hyunin.
Wait,
the brains of H2K managing to be in the right place at the right time. If they were still dealing with Rekkles and Nif,
they wouldn't have killed the turret.
So we do see Kasing 0-0-3 really setting up H2K here in their opening match of week four. Second tower, second dragon secured to back up their two towers. Shook, that's the second blue buff in a row that is stolen, so not too bad.
And now with Dragon gone, you can send your AD carry to the top lane instead and push in that tower because there's no global objective he has to be on the bottom side for. Oh, to Amna though, 1v4.
Oh, this is so much trouble. There's damage on Shook. Shook's tanking the tower. He manages to get away, should be able to heal up. What will they lose in reply? Elements get one kill, and it looks like somebody's recalling. We see Lulex and Ryu hammering away on this inner turret. Rekkles is waiting on the sidelines. Froggen is still going to stick around up top. They've set their sights on Hyunin a lot. But two members of Elements we see on the hunt coming out. Odawambe turns his attention to Wicked. We do see that vengeful maelstrom. Here comes Lulex. Lulex is around. Odawambe is tanking the turret. Cataclysm's going to be able to kill the first champion in this fight. And now they turn their attention to Wicked. Wicked's going to be taken out next. A well-executed tower dive. H2K have got the coordination, the control, and they are arresting Elements on the map.
He keeps looking for these picks, but they're not there. I mean, it's very hard for him to do anything, and you see Elements try and do something at least to get back in this game, knowing that if they are behind, H2K can just take everything. It was the same, it was a bad situation for them where they could never get a flank in. With their heavy engage comp, they ran back then. Now it's a different situation, you just don't have to engage for yourself, but Shook is going in.
That was a flash into the knockup. Ryu gets caught again. Collateral damage thrown down from the backline. Odawamne's got five members hammering down on the giant tree. Where is Hyunin? Death Sentence connects onto Wicked. Boomerang Blade comes up on the hunt being thrown up. Hyunin's got one on the board as Shook is taken out. A flash away from Lulex is going to keep Rekkles locked up. And Elements, despite initiating that fight, come out worse for wear. They've lost one. So it's at least giving him some gold, Randu and Zoman, and that Ninja Tabi already completed, reducing the damage of one, and that's Wicked dead on the background. I didn't even see how the damage got to him.
I must admit, I'm a little bit surprised Lockett is actually on Odawamne. Because you've gotten all this global gold, that's where normally your support can get a fairly early Lockett for himself. Instead, Kasing decided to get the Ruby Sidestone, so he wants that one extra ward because he knows, again, it's going to be a game of vision and a game of H2K forcing objectives now. H2K, and use all the global gold to get the Lockett on Kasing instead.
Lions managed to recall from the top lane, but they're going to be late to this turret. H2K have found a window of opportunity. They have punished Elements. They've got the turret, and they're going in the inhibitor. Inhibitor's down to a third on the hunt, thrown out from Hyunin. He's looking for targets. Charm doesn't connect. H2K get the objectives and get the hell out of Dodge. Inhibitor down, Elements. Rekkles dealing with them. H2K are so confident, they're starting Baron.
Wait, you have teleport in your top lane and you send your AD carry to deal with the bottom lane. Clearly Elements are just gonna give up this Baron here or hope for Shook if he can like steal it, but no, it's not even nearby. So Elements actually deciding to say we can't fight for Baron no matter what. So we just give Rekkles the farm in the bottom lane.
Let's see if he can reach in with that Blade of the Ruined King. And how much deep vision H2K sets up on the back line.
Sugar's looking to fight here.
Well, let's see what they can do. Kasing gets slowed. Odawamne's gone in. Ryu's going to flank from the side.
Didn't work.
The first victim is Nif. Cataclysm goes out. We see the flash forward. Charm doesn't connect. Wicked splitting to the left. Rekkles splitting to the right. Wild Growth is up this time around. Orbit Deception's not going to be enough. Froggen re-engages as he gets caught up in the air. the collateral damage plus Froggen. They get one, lose two, and an inhibitor. Baron buff on those minions. H2K, they're on the Nexus turret. They're going for a 30-minute victory. H2K are there. Kjarnan's got the damage to finish this one off. Elements are not going to be able to defend. And H2K with a stunning victory over Elements. Rise above showed that their substitution pays off. They've got the win.
And honestly, that was a stomp.